You head to the west. I mean, it's cold too. I don't know if you want to spend a whole lot of time outside, like you were saying, but still, partially covered roadways west of the metro. You get out towards Waukee, and they have got completely covered roadways. That area highlighted in pink is where it's kind of treacherous still to travel. And any of these areas in blue, still finding some slick spots. So eastern half of the state, just really a couple trouble spots. Otherwise, areas like Indianola down through Ottumwa are looking a little bit safer for travel. But good news, DOT does have quite a few plows out, mainly attacking those trouble spots just west of the metro in those areas highlighted in pink. So those should be improving as we head into the next couple hours here. Here's a look at one of those plows out near Guthrie Center off I-44 East. So still a little bit of slick spots you can see out on the roadway there. But thanks, guys, for doing the good work and getting out there and getting those roads cleared. 19 right now. Our temperature continues to drop throughout the day. We're seeing a little bit of light snow out there. Check out that breeze, though. 21 miles an hour. That's making it feel like 3 degrees out. Bundle up if you're headed out, because it's only going to get colder. Well, near teens below for Sioux City and Spencer. Single digits across much of central and southern Iowa. And areas to the east just a little bit warmer. But colder air is coming for you too. And for some of us, still chances for a little bit of light snow. And that is heading towards that spot where travel right now is difficult. So not exactly going to help things there. Metro, though, is looking relatively dry. We've got some isolated snow showers popping up ahead of that main batch. Otherwise, we look regionally here, and there's not a lot going on. We had all that snow yesterday. Some spots along the North Shore up in Minnesota saw 2 feet of snow. So we didn't quite get that, and we won't. But if you are traveling to the east towards Chicago or so, Green Bay, you get a chance for a little bit of light snow and perhaps some light rain, too. If you're traveling to the north, plan on colder air, mainly up near, I'd say, Fargo or so, where they could see highs in the single digits. But for us, temperatures continuing to taper back. Those snow chances will greatly taper back into the evening. We'll even break up some of that cloud cover. That wind is going to stay pretty gusty out there out of the northwest, 15 to 30 miles per hour. So breaking it down hour by hour, there's that snow to the north, and I wouldn't doubt that we see that continue through central portions of the state too. We head into the day on Saturday, and a lot of the cloud cover that we've got here is eventually going to break up for us. As far as how much snow you can expect out of that batch that we've got making its way through the state, it's not going to be much. We are talking fractions of an inch for northern portions of the state, 6/10 of an inch for Mason City, and light dustings for central and southern portions of the state. So still staying chilly out there, 23 degrees. Again, the high, it's going to continue to drop as we head throughout the afternoon and evening, and that'll put us near zero for wind chills tonight. Northwestern portions of the state, again, will be much colder than that. 10 degrees, the overnight low, though it will never feel like that. But the next 24 to 48 hours, we're going to be hard pressed to feel any kind of warm here. You look to the northwest, low to mid teens below, and we head into Saturday, still seeing single digits for wind chills across most of the state. And well, it's just going to be cold out for a while. Low to mid 20s out there today, and low to mid teens for northwestern portions of the state for highs. Again, feels like temperatures below zero there. We head into your weekend, and we are eventually going to warm up, but tomorrow is still looking chilly. Middle 20s on Saturday, mid 40s on Sunday. But that's about as good as we are going to feel until the end of next week. You look at New Year's Eve and New Year's Day, we got a chance for a little bit of snow again on Monday. Shouldn't amount to much, but again, could make roads slick. Look at New Year's Day morning, though. If you have got celebration plans and you're going to be outside, you might be a little crazy, because we could be seeing wind chills teens to 20s below.
But